Hey, what's up, guys? Tougie here, back again. And if you are watching this video, that means that the NHL 20 reveal trailer has dropped at the NHL Awards. There will be a link in the description to this full trailer over on the EA side of things. I highly recommend that you check it out. Now, because of my affiliation with EA, I am getting to see this early. It is the morning of the NHL Awards, but I have not watched the trailer yet. I want to watch it, you know, and get my initial reactions out there, my first take. Now, obviously, I got a look at NHL 20 back at the end of April when I got to go out to Vancouver, which still doesn't feel like that happened. So there's still probably going to be a lot that I'm not going to be able to talk about, depending on what they show in this trailer. But anything they do show, I'm open to talk about. So I'm excited to see what they show. It is just an initial reveal trailer, so there won't be much. But if there's anything they show, I'll be able to talk about it at least perhaps a little bit more in depth. So I am excited. Let's get this going. My initial reaction to the NHL 20 reveal trailer.
Coming from Arizona.
Also, I'm a reaction. Okay, number one. Yeah, that's Auston Matthews, isn't it? I heard coming from Arizona, and I know exactly who that is. So that's nice. I know a lot of people were expecting it to be Sidney Crosby. It is, in fact, Auston Matthews on the cover. This is the first ever reaction video I've ever done on this channel, so now I feel like a total loser.
It's different. Most of my friends played football, baseball, basketball. They asked why hockey, and I figured, why not?
All right, there was a little bit in there. There was a little bit in there. Hold on.
Most of my friends played football, baseball.
There was a basketball. Little bit in that little fast forwarding that I liked. So yeah, a little bit of gameplay there, but obviously nothing. It just shows the slight shot. Let me go down to playback speed. Now see, this is why I said you could watch it on their side of things, because I'm going to be pausing a lot.
Why not?
All right, so it didn't really show much, but that's my keen eye for it, man. I got to pay attention.
Why not? Because hockey doesn't need more followers.
I wasn't afraid.
Hockey needs all the followers. Auston Matthews and casual. Look at you and your camo. Now, okay, if I'm not mistaken. Now, one of the things that they have done, okay, that is the canal. So they have added more outdoor spots to ones, including basically like the canal in Ottawa. I don't remember the exact name for it, but it does look pretty sick.
Kind of take a risk.
There you go. So yeah, you got a better look at it there. Hold on. So yeah, they added it. It looks really sick in game. Yeah, cool. I'll give them credit. Another one right there, the old outdoor farm for the whole ones kind of deal. They added a couple of them. Added a couple of other things as well, like the I'm glad I paused it right there. The face masks as well. So a couple more new things to customize, you know, for your pro and such. Look at PK. What a guy. They keep doing this, though, for the editing style, damn it. Like, every couple of seconds, it's, hey, here's something new, but they flash it really quickly. We'll keep it on 0.5 for the moment. So, like, right there, I was trying to see what was new there. It just looks like a Golden Knight getting burned like he was on the penalty kill.
Person.
Yeah.
Again, the old face mask. Yeah, it's a ski mask, basically.
Now.
I don't really care about the audio.
It's not just about getting it done.
All right, I do, because that sounds really weird. Let's at least bump it up to back to normal. We're going to be switching a lot, I'd imagine. Let's see.
It's the style that comes with it.
All right, again, they're going to cut forward. There was just more face masks. There, you get the point. All right. Ooh. Big fan. Does he have an injured hand like he did in the Stanley Cup final? That's my question. Now, it might be tough to catch, but they worked hard on shooting animations this year, and I imagine that's not going to be the only example. Let me see if I can drop that back a little bit. Just watch the way Pasternak squares up for the shot and then follows through the leg kickouts. That was perhaps the main thing I was impressed by gameplay-wise. The new shooting looks better. It feels better. Whether or not that translates to it being a bit more effective and as a result, you know, obviously the same thought of the same shots go in happens year in and year out. Whether or not that continues to be the case, we'll see. But at the very least, it looks better.
Young guys aren't afraid.
Also, fucking Nasher and TDI. Attack it! You fucking. Look at this. I mean, look at the boys in the trailer. Especially tactics.
The old guy,
franchise dude. What a guy. That's pretty sweet that they put them in the trailer. Connor on the farm.
Needs to be a hockey player. And yeah, they're putting on a show.
Ovi into the glass, Ovi with the cup. Ovi in the farm.
Because
why not? Alright, so there's another example too. Pickups and the transition into shooting. So just, I don't know, like a much more natural reach for Matthews to get the puck instead of the weird fucking wrist-breaking deal that it used to be. And the shot followed through is pretty sweet as well. So like I said, that's right there too. That's one of the big examples. Let's watch this again. So again, just the catch and release from Matthews looks 1,000 times better. Half the time, if you tried to do that, something cross-body related, your guy would just do like the weird kind of half quick shot and it just looked terrible and very rarely worked.
And
that looks sick though. Anderson getting beat there might bother some people, but this right here is what you'll notice. This tap-in on the far hand side. So initially, and getting to talk to people like Ben Ross about this, you kind of helps you explain it. So initially, here, let me see if I can get that on the split screen. Or on the split screen, freeze frame. All right, so right there, it's like a mix of him taking a stride and almost thinking like, oh, I'm gonna wind up for a slap shot here. And then, you know, it kind of kicks in how close he is, what the situation is, and instead, he goes for the chip. Pretty sweet too. They got the actual Matthew Selly in, which is nice. That was a sweet transition to PK taking the shot in real life to taking it in game. Spot on.
Of your own.
Spot on. Again, just more of the customization stuff for ones. I wasn't over. Oh my god! I forgot that they added that. They not only did they add in new, of course, customization things, which, you know, I know that's not going to be the biggest thing for everyone. People are going to be wondering, well, what about this? What about this? What about this? And obviously, I have things, you know, when I got to go there, I'm like, so what about this, this, and this, and this? And it's all stuff that, of course, if you've been a part of this channel for a while, you know that we would have discussed it. But still, for as popular as ones was, you know, good on them for adding like the new rinks and stuff, the new customization. And then they've added new Sellies as well. And I hate that word. But fucking A, if the Marchand one doesn't look amazing. I love that. I didn't get to see that with Brad Marchand's character model. Although, Marshy with the A. I'm just gonna say, no.
Yeah. It just looks weird. Embrace beam.
And that's the big one. They added the, they didn't add a ton for the Storm Surge, but they at least added that, and it looks fucking awesome. And at the very least, for those who really care about, like, EASHL customization, that's a big one, in terms of, you know, you get more than just, like, the Ranger salute now. See what this Matthews deal looks like. Just a better follow-through on the curl and drag.
You why? You already know.
I think that's probably going to be it, right? Okay. Alright, so another replication of real world versus in-game. I believe that's one of the things as well that they did was they tried to get more, I guess, signature shots. Weber from the point. Okay, he didn't have to show Ryan O'Reilly in Boston. Didn't have to do that. It's accurate, though. Lock your skill and lock your style. What's your name? Fits. There you go. September 13th. Austin Matthews, the cover boy. So I had a feeling, of course, it's a 1 minute and 12 second long trailer. I knew they wouldn't show much. But, you know, I will say, you know, them showcasing again the further additions to one. It's a trailer, right? That's the best way for me to put this. It's a trailer. It's what you would expect, in a way, from a reveal trailer. Again, you can't look at this and be like, oh, so all they've done is update ones and shooting. There's obviously more, And it's the same thing every year where people, and I already know like that was the best. Okay, we'll leave that up. There's going to be more. It's the same thing every year for them. Here's the reveal trailer, and then they start breaking out the deep dives and everything, which obviously I'm looking forward to for reasons, numerous reasons, again, that I can't say anything about. But, with what they showcased on this trailer, at the very least, it does hit some of the key points. And like I said, and obviously, you know, I'm not going to sugarcoat it, but, you know, some of the things like the new celebrations and everything, cool. I know a lot of people are concerned about gameplay. Here's my deal. You know, it's going to be the same thing that it was last year for me, right? Like, I really enjoyed the beta, and then they changed it. So, from what I saw, I can again say, and just from what I can talk about based off of this trailer with, like, the shooting and everything, I'm optimistic, yet again, for NHL. It's just, we'll see what changes that they've made to the game once the beta comes out, if there is one this year. No confirmation on that as far as I know. But we'll see what this game is like and how it evolves, because, I mean, again, I certainly had my difference in opinion with other YouTubers and such on how the beta played, but I certainly enjoyed it more than the regular game. This was promising. I'm not going to say, you know, and obviously I can't, but I'm not going to sit here and be like, yes, it's going to be the greatest. I don't know. I thought last year's game, I thought 19 had the potential to be the greatest. Didn't work out that way. It could have been better. But again, for an initial reveal trailer, I thought it was a well put together trailer at the very least, if we're going to just talk about that. But some of the stuff that they showed, I'm excited for you guys to be able to see more of it. And I will say the cover, you know, if that's the cover art, it's a hell of a lot better than last year's with PK. The whole 19 sports titles cover arts are so weird. Not that I really care too much about cover art, but I give it credit. And he doesn't look as deformed as Connor McDavid did 2 years ago. So we're just winning on all fronts. But that is... Mwah! I love that so much. But guys, we'll be out of here for now, because otherwise I'll just sit here and rant and ramble. But overall, for me, it's a reveal trailer. It did its job. Obviously, you know, you'd kind of hope for a little bit more for them to showcase. But at the end of the day, it is just a reveal trailer. Give it time, and there will be more info out. Whether or not you're happy or disappointed, well, we'll find out in the future, won't we? I'll see you guys later. Have a good one. Goodbye.